Hi everybody, Joey here again and welcome back. So in today's video, we're going to build a bio-pellet reactor for saltwater aquariums. Now, when I set my saltwater aquarium up, I knew that there was three projects I wanted to do right away, which is the bio-pellet reactor, a nano skimmer, as well as an auto top-off. We'll be covering the bio-pellet reactor in today's video, and then in some future videos, we'll get back to the skimmer, as well as the auto top-off. But if you can't wait, I've actually already built those projects in the past, so you can go back into my past videos and check those out. Now, if you're not familiar with what a bio-pellet reactor is in the first place, basically they allow you to remove nitrates from your aquarium system. And this is due to the biopolymer pellets that we're going to add to the reactor, but we're going to come back to exactly how this works after I show you how to build it. First of all, you're going to need some biopolymer beads. Now, these are available in a wide range of brands, but these are going to act as your source of carbon for the bacteria. You'll also need a small aquarium pump that is preferably adjustable. The one I'm using is 80 gallons per hour. However, I can adjust the flow, and it only uses 4 watts of power. The best part is I only paid $7.99 on Amazon. Now, if you use this pump, you'll need a little bit of knitting mesh as well. You just need a small amount, although you could use any sort of mesh and place it over the output of the pump. The reason being is that when the pump shuts off and the pellets settle, they can get inside the motor, so you want to be able to stop them somehow. You'll also need some glue or some silicone, and of course a water bottle. And for this to be the most efficient, you want to make sure that it is round and smooth as opposed to rigid. Now, if this nano-sized reactor is not good enough for you, you can go ahead and get some 4-inch acrylic pipe and build a giant size one like I'm going to do for my 375 gallon in the future. This build should take you no longer than 5 minutes, which is the beauty of it. It's very simple. Start off by drilling a hole in the cap of your bottle and make sure that it fits on snugly to your pump. Then glue the mesh down over top of the output of the pump, but do not obstruct the ability to put the bottle back in place. Now you need to drill a bunch of holes at the top of the bottle. I prefer to drill much smaller holes and drill a lot of them so the bio pellets cannot exit the bottle. Drilling them at the top though means that the chances of them getting out are slim anyways because the bio pellets are only going to fill up half this bottle. Now we just gotta put it all together. Now, if you've never dealt with bio-pellets in the past, there's tons of documentation and instructions on how to start one of these up, but ideally you want to start off with about 25% of the amount you need. In my case, I'm going ahead and filling it up just for this video to give you a visual. Then attach the pump with the cap on it back onto the bottle. And you're done. Now, if you didn't soak the bio-pellets for about 24 hours prior to putting it in the bottle, they will float a bit, but that's not too much of a problem. Once you turn the pump on, what you want to look for is that the bio-pellets are simply continuously moving around and they're not compact or packing together at any point. You want the water to freely flow through it, but you don't want them to go crazy throughout the bottle, so make sure that you adjust the flow of the pump to make it just right. Now, if you're going with this design, it's best to put it in your sump and put it after your mechanical filter, but before your protein skimmer. After your mechanical filtration, so that you filter out all the particles from the water before it reaches the bio-pellet reactor, yet before the skimmer, because the bacteria that's going to be living on the bottle will be dying off eventually and exit the bottle, so you'll want your protein skimmer to be able to remove that. For me, I've been running mine on my aquarium for about 4 weeks, and I went from having nitrates to zero nitrates. Now, typically, this will take about 6 weeks to kick in and cycle the bacteria on the bio-pellets. However, if you want to speed that up, you can add bacterias like Bio-Digest by Prodibio, and that will speed the process up tremendously. Now, there's a few different types of bacteria in a bottle that will work, so I suggest you do your research and find out what's most affordable to you and available to you. Within a couple of weeks, you'll notice that your nitrates in your aquarium are undetectable, and even your phosphates come down a bit. You see, this will remove nitrates and phosphates to a ratio of 16 to 1. So all in all, I'm about $9 into this project, plus another $6 worth of the bio pellets that I used. Now, the entire container cost me $30, but I'm only using $6 of that at each time. It should also be said that the bio pellets don't last forever. You do have to constantly replace them as they're consumed. But usually you won't have to do that for several weeks to several months, depending on your system. Now, this bacteria still has a life cycle, so it eventually dies, and that fluidization of the bio pellets knocks off that old bacteria, and new bacteria can take its place. But that old bacteria will be tossed back into your aquarium if you don't have a good protein skimmer after it, or perhaps some sort of a mechanical trap to make sure that you trap it all. So for $15, you too can build your own bioreactor and have a big impact on your aquarium. But how does this work? Well, the bio-pellets are a biodegradable source of carbon. Now, if you give certain species of bacteria a source of carbon, they can consume it and basically use it as a food source, so they can consume additional nutrients in the aquarium, like nitrates and phosphates. Now, if you were to build this exact reactor that I've shown you, this would easily handle about a 75-gallon aquarium using about 250 milliliters of these bio-pellets in a 500-milliliter bottle. However, the more pellets that you use and the bigger the bottle is, the larger the aquarium this could handle. Now, these bio-pellets have been in the aquarium hobby for a few years now, and there's tons of documentation and discussions out there that will allow you to really dive deep into whether or not you need or could want a bio-pellet reactor. So I suggest you doing your research before attacking this project. Although this is a really affordable and extremely effective project to do, so it's up to you and what you do here. Anyways, I hope that you guys enjoyed today's project. I'd also like to thank you for watching, and if you join me next Sunday, I'll have a new do-it-yourself project for you.